the grace of God.
Amen. How nice it is to be here with you. Did I tell y'all when I was here last time, did I tell you about the elephant that was in the swimming pool? Well, I probably did. But anyway, the elephant was in the swimming pool. The little mouse was on the chair, and lawn chair. And he said to the elephant, said, "Get out of the pool." Well, the elephant didn't move. He said, I said, "Get out of the pool." He didn't move. Finally, the little mouse stood up as tall as he could, squeaked as loud as he could, said, "I said, get out of the pool." Elephant got out and come around and said, "What do you want?" He said, "Oh, nothing. I just wanted to be sure you wasn't wearing my swimming trunks." So I tell him again. Amen. Just, you know, I greeted you that way because I know I can. Amen. Y'all are ready to laugh. You're ready to cry. You're ready to praise the Lord. You're ready to preach it. That's so great. That's so great. And I wanted to thank the choir this morning. I thought that was the adult choir. And I got to looking around and listening a little bit, and it wasn't. It was our younger people. Amen. And I enjoyed all the singing today. It's just been so good. Enjoy the fact that my wife is here. She got a new hairdo yesterday. She kind of come in swinging yesterday. So that's good. Amen. Brother and Sister Shields, and also Pastor Shield, we enjoy y'all so much. Enjoy being with you. I got something good to report. Bishop Shields has finally learned to drive. I think he ought to go down and get his license. He drove me yesterday night. We started leaving. I said, "Drive if you want me to." Of course, his pride wouldn't let an old man drive. He just did super. He just did super. He's liable to live a while longer. All right. Love y'all, and we'll preach by the help of the Lord. If you will turn to John, the fifth chapter. And to save just a little time, we'll go to the fifth verse. And a certain man was there, which had an infirmity 38 years. When Jesus saw him lie and knew that he had been now a long time in that case, he said unto him, "Wilt thou be made whole?" The impotent man answered him, "Sir, I have no man when the water is troubled to put me in the pool. But while I am coming, another steppeth down before me." And Jesus said unto him, "Rise, take up thy bed, and walk." And immediately the man was made whole, took up his bed, walked. You may be seated. I would like this morning to preach from a subject that, from the text of the circumventer. the serpent. Jesus has been called Alpha. He's been called Omega. Been called Savior. Friend of sinners. Healer. Lord. Bridegroom. Rose of Sharon. Bright and morning star. Prince of Peace, Lord of Glory. He's been called so many, by so many names. But let's try Circumventor. Just kind of add that to it. Well, you see the story. This is one of the greatest stories in the Bible as far as I'm personally concerned. Let's start with 10. 10 years. 10 years is a long time. You may not think so after living it, but 10 years is really a long time while you're living it. When my wife and I went to Dallas, Texas, and without anything, didn't have any money, we had $380 and everything we owned in our car, and our daughter was little. And we stayed 10 years and built a church that's the greatest church in Dallas area right now. And we ran as high as 247 in 10 years. And when you think of 10 years, that seems like that was a big spot in our lives, 10 years. But then whenever you think of 20 years, that takes the heart out of a lifetime in a sense. 20 years. Then 30 years. 30 years is a long time. But what about 40 years minus 2? 38 years this man was laying at this pool. It's hard to fathom. He really wanted to be healed. He had a desire to be like everyone else. He had a desire to walk. And I don't know, he was probably laying down. And every time that the waters would be troubled, he planned all year, every year, he planned on making it down to the pool. And he thought, well, this next year, I got to do it. I just got to make it. And he didn't make it, and he just kept planning the year and couldn't. I don't know where he wriggled. I don't know where he was on his hand, on his knees, and trying to get down there. All I know that every time before he could make it, somebody would step down before him. Somebody that was apparently in a better condition than he was. And all of a sudden one day he looked to the side and he saw a pair of sandals that he had not been used to seeing. And he was laying there, and it was the Lord. And the Lord said to him, "Would you like to be healed?" story that we just read and that I just told you, basically, he goes into all the story to let the Lord know. Well, so here's everyone getting poised, getting set. Everyone stays all year on go. And the Lord just simply looks at him and says, "Arise!" Just exactly what he could do. But the Lord is a serpent. Amen. He cuts through all of that. He didn't say, "Now I'll see that you get to the head of the line." He didn't say, "I'll talk to these people here." He didn't say that I'll stand in guard while you get to the water. No, he just said, "Arise! Pick up your head." And that's what he can say to you right now. And all of that. And they have to see, you hear the machines running and little noises all through, and we'll check it, no one, about 20 minutes of the hour or two or day and all. But Jesus, he just cuts through all the red tape. Praise God. Amen. He doesn't have to wait for anything. He doesn't have to check a thermometer. He doesn't have to order a pill. He doesn't have to do anything. Praise God. And he's here this morning to cut through right your situation right now. In Jesus' name. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, Lord, come on. The Lord can heal on the way to the hospital.
Amen. That's
true. I was down in South Carolina, or up, or wherever it is, Jones, all the impression. But I don't know if I'm up or down. But I was in South Carolina, and a lady testified, and she said, my son, backslid and married a Catholic girl and said he never told her anything about the church, and said our grandson, their little boy, 2 years old, last week got a bottle cap hung in his throat, and said they had him in the ambulance, and my daughter-in-law and my son were sitting opposite each other, and the boy, it became obvious that he was going to die, on the way to the hospital. And so the boy looked at his wife and said to her, "Pray." And she did some things. And he said, "No, no, no." He said, "Say Jesus." And she said, "Our Father." He said, "No, no, Jesus. Say Jesus." And so she said, "Jesus." He said, "Say it loud." And so they sat there and both of them screaming across the boy, "Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus." And that bottle cap popped out. I said, if God's not bigger than a hospital, we all got a problem. Praise God. Oh, hallelujah. I feel the Holy Ghost here. I feel the power of God. Oh, glory. You know what? I believe healing is in this house. I believe healing is here. Praise God. Don't you think so? Don't you think God's made up to heal this morning? God. Somebody's got something that they just can't get rid of. Let's believe in God. Going to do it this morning in the name of Jesus, because he's a circumventer. Praise God. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. He's here before you got here. He'll be here after you go. He's all the time with you. He goes home with you. Took that little old church in Louisiana, whenever Joe and I first started preaching, just because we didn't take it. We didn't accept it. They asked us to take it. We said no. And we was evangelizing, and they said, "Well, what about just that we can get a pastor?" I said, "Okay." And so we've been in the old rickety parsonage 2 days. And the phone rang. I remember it was on the side of the wall. And the phone rang, and a backslider down at the hospital, the little old clinic, said, "Brother Martin, if you don't get down here, Uncle Charlie's going to lose his leg." I didn't know where the hospital was. I didn't know who Uncle Charlie was. I didn't know a man had called. So I went down there and I walked in and had a little ward-like situation. And there was a man's leg, it was great big and red and orange and blue and green, and it's swollen. You could see they was going to take his leg off in 4 hours. And so I just walked up there, put my hand on his head, and I said, "In Jesus' name, I ask you to heal Uncle Charlie." And whenever I did, that leg went just like the other one. He's a circumventer. He's a circumventer, I tell you. We baptized Uncle Charlie, and he got the Holy Ghost at 85 years old. Yeah, I thought that's old then. Really? Oh, if he can heal Uncle Charlie, he can heal you. Praise God. Praise God. That blind Bartimaeus. And he was just out there, and he heard a noise, and what's going on? And they said, "Jesus is passing by."
Yeah.
And when they said, "Jesus is passing by," he just began to scream. "Jesus! Jesus! Jesus!" Corbin, Kentucky. And our transmission was started acting crazy. An old Cadillac we had. And we pulled off the service station. And they said, no, that's that service station there. You have to go there. They do work on cars. So I went down there and asked the man, could he do it? He said, yeah, he would. He said, but you might as well go to that motel there and get your room, because it's not going to be quick, I'll tell you that. At least a couple of days. So next morning I went in and tried to kind of check on it, goose things along a little. He said, Brother Mark, we know what it is. It's not the transmission, it's the clutch. But said, we have to have a special tool to put that on, back on when we get it off. And we don't have one. And we went to the Cadillac and we wouldn't launch one. And we can't buy one. I said, what you gonna do? He said, well, there's an old man that lives way up in the mountains. And said, if we can get him come down here, he can make us a tool. He's contrary, but said if he'll come, he can do it. So the next day that evening I went in and there was an old man in there with a beard, white beard, all except the snuff and tobacco that was in it. And it was long. And he had his overalls on and he didn't have any use for buttons. And so he didn't speak. I didn't either. They told me how he was. And so they said, if you watch him work, he'll just get up and leave. Won't say nothing. And so I looked through a little window thing. And I saw him just in there. He had an old piece of paper and a pencil. And he was drawing. So I just went back to the motel. Came back the next day and they said, it's ready. It's ready. I said, you get your tools? He said, Cadillac's got one, and we've got one. And it's right there. So I want to tell you something. We know someone that specializes. Do you know what? We know somebody that has all the parts. You see, this body that we have, God made it. And they talk about nutrients and so forth, going food, going to this and going to that, and talking about this little valve here and talking about this little, what do we call it? Not gizzard. You've got all these little arteries and leaders and all of this is going all over, and they say there's a million miles of it all wrapped up in our bodies, and we've got such sensitive parts in us. But do you know that God specializes? Amen. He made us. That's original equipment. That's all original. He did it. He made it to start with. So if he made it, knows where everything is, then he can make it a part. Amen. He can make a part. Why, he's got the cutest little old heart valves that you've ever seen. And they're not made out of pigs, and they're not made out of plastic. Amen. They're brand new. They're brand new. Amen. They're brand new. in your life. And those little old cushions, it's got to go in there to keep you from hurting. Do you know he's got them by the millions? Oh, hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. He's a circumventor. He's got it all. And he can do it right now in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. He can do it right. When I had deterioration of the spine for 18 years, I had deterioration of the spine and I couldn't walk. Hardly I had to sit down and preach and all of that and never knew what I was going to do the next day. And old Brother Russell from up there in Kentucky, amen, he asked us to come get prayed for and he put his hand on my head and the other on my back. And said, in the name of Jesus, heal Brother Martyr's back. And I felt something warm go across me.
All right, all right.
Praise God. And I've never had the problem since. Praise God. But he's a psychopathic. He put it all back. He put it all together. I told the best specialist in the Southwest. When he was examining me, I said, sir, if you'll operate on me, I'll get on my stomach right now. He said, I wouldn't touch you for $1 million. But the Lord could touch him because he made it. Praise God. He made it. And he's got brand new parts to put in there. Praise God. It's lasted well over 25 to 30 years now. Amen. It's still working.
Yeah.
the circumventer, the circumventer. Man told me, and I do wish that I would have asked him some questions. I'm sorry, I should have asked him. I should have got some names and places, but I don't have. I just have to tell you what the man told me. He said there was one of the saints in Arkansas. They said the man, he told me, he said, I had a friend that was a Buddhist. We worked together, did welding. And he said, we got to be close friends. He said, one day he came out and he was sad. There was something wrong with him, and I knew it. And so I said, what's wrong? What's the matter? He said, I've got a boy that's 5 years old. He's never walked before. And he said, this morning when I left, some days it gets on him, it's worse than others. And when I saw him so helpless when I left, the saint said to him, would you do me a favor? He said, well, sure, I'll do you a favor. He said, when you get home tonight, I want you to put your hand on his head. And I want you to say, Jesus. And I don't want you to say anything else. I want you to just keep saying, Jesus. And you just keep saying, Jesus. And just keep saying, Jesus. Amen. Just keep saying, don't say nothing else. And that next morning, whenever he got to work, here comes this man in his truck. He got out making 2 or 3 strides at a time. And he went to him and said, what's going on? He said, I did what you told me last night. And he said, my boy walked to the truck with me this morning. He's a servant. Let's all stand. He's a servant. Praise God. Praise God. Let's praise the Lord. Let's praise the Lord.
This many people, there are many needs in this room. Your child may be able to walk, but we have at least one child that doesn't talk much. I'd love to see God just do great things here today. You may have a need that nobody knows about. Can I ask you to step out from where you are? Let's show God we need him. He's touched, the book said, with the feeling of our infirmities. Doesn't matter what problem you brought with you to church today, it's not God's will for you to take it on alone. He's here today. He's able. The book said to do exceeding abundantly above all we can think or ask. Let your need be known to him today. I assure you, he hears.